The DeLuca donation is a gift of 27,000 acres to the University of Florida IFAS. It's possibly one of the largest gifts that the university has ever received. The property is beautiful. It's well managed. It's diverse. It's been maintained to standards that very few pieces of property anywhere in the state of Florida are. So it becomes a living laboratory for our scientists and staff to study what the ecosystems of Florida have been, are now, and might be in the future.
From the research perspective, this gives us in IFAS an opportunity to look at bigger questions. We've been able to look at small areas, and due to property fragmentation, we can't always go across the entire landscape. But here we can go across 8 miles. So it's amazing. As I talk about this to my colleagues, I can see every unit in IFAS be involved here. We have the native rangeland, we have the semi-improved pastures, and then we have native pastures, and then we also have improved pastures, and then agroecosystems like the citrus production areas. So there's different things that we could do, like carbon sequestration, water quality, habitat, not only for wildlife, but also pollinators. We know of two endangered species that are here right now, and one of those is the red cockaded woodpecker, and the other is the Florida grasshopper sparrow. And as far as, other species, we're sure they're here. This big of an area, it's hard to find them all.
This land, because it's such a large piece of property, represents two things, both what Florida used to be like before development and what it can be like in the future. There's been so much change in Florida. We've lost so much property to change of the ecosystem by development that maintaining property in the state it was 50 years ago is so important to understand where Florida has come from and maybe where it needs to go in the future.
We can actually start to answer some of those big, big questions that we've not been able to answer before. Gifts like this are so important because it would be impossible for UF to get this resource.
And it takes donors that will help us create these living laboratories so that we can think about the past, present, and future. For those that donated this piece of property, I'd like to thank them for their vision and their foresight to preserve such a large piece of property that represents a significant part of the ecosystem of Florida, which will then allow us to think more about what it looked like in the past, do we want to maintain that, or what it might look like in the future.
The hope is that when we do research, we find answers to questions, and this land absolutely gives us that opportunity to do that.